Hello, ABG is back, and today we'll be doing an unboxing for Dungeon Drop Deluxe. Finally, my copy of Dungeon Drop Deluxe have come from Kickstarter. This is not a sponsored post. I paid full price for the deluxe version and includes the shipping. And I'm in Singapore, and I'm guessing because of the COVID-19 situation, shipping has been delayed a bit, and thus I only got it this week. The week that I'm referring to is the first week of April. And for viewers out there, I hope you stay safe, stay home, stop the spread of COVID, let's fight COVID. And well, if you have games like this, that it's for 1 to 4 players, you can actually avoid social interaction for the time being and game yourself. So the game is for age 8 and above, plays about 20 minutes. So as mentioned, I got the deluxe version, and it comes with the complete add-on bundle, which is nice. So let's go on with the unboxing. So it has been a while that I could do videos again. Haven't been in the best of health, as some of you might know. Was in and out of hospital for a bit. Not COVID, thankfully, but something almost equally bad. But let's not talk about that. Let's just come and talk about the game. So the game comes in a nice compact box. This is the size of my hand. So as a point of comparison, it's not very big. It's a good size, and to be honest, my shelving need games that have good game, good replayable gameplay and small size, because most of the games nowadays are just getting bigger and bigger with so many components, minis and all. Okay, so did I actually get them with sleeves? I'm not sure if I remember paying for sleeves, but I'm sure I probably did, or came as a stretch goals. So it comes with a nice, well, the print is nice. I'm not so sure how well this will last after time, because you can see it's I think it's neoprene printed. Good feel, good felt back. Design is great. Enjoy the design. And let's see what we have. I haven't really read the rules yet, so I know that it's a game with lots of cubes, so you drop them. There's also some cubes with a very small looking D6, so cool stuff. Seems to be a lot of components. I'm sure these are the characters, and some monsters. There's even this keyring thingy. Not so sure if we need that for the game. Some nice metal cubes. Not so sure why some of these are individually packed. I probably have to read up more, because we have quite a number of small, nicely packed. Oh! Okay, let's just take out all the small, nicely packed ones. So I'm guessing this must be some kind of a stretch goals. It's been some time since I backed this, so I can't remember exactly all the things that have been there. But this die thing looks really cool. This is the only one with some weight, and it just looks cool. Let me see if I can get it focused. Yeah, check it out. So this, to be honest, this weighs more than this. Let's try again. I think this probably still weighs more than this stuff. So you can tell this is something good. Anyway, back in the box. So there's a nice, I mean, to be honest, this reminds me of the standard memo pad boxes that we have in offices. And I'm sure this is the rule book. Okay. Just put the box aside, put the clutter aside. This is nice. This is the rule book. To be honest, I mean, the rule doesn't look that long, and right, it comes in a small size. I hate it when you have those giant, you know, the standard box size where you have, for example, your ticket to ride box size, and the rule book is the size of the ticket to ride box. I mean, seriously. Okay. Stuff to punch. What's this? Prince Price. Skeleton Skull. This may be the mini expansion, I don't know. And this is the rest of the cards where I think I have the sleeves on. So this means that this game is going to be operational from day one. And now on to do some of the boring stuff, which is punching tokens. So far, the quality of the cardboard is not my favorite, to be honest. I would say that the cardboard quality is meh. Meh-ish. I'm not so sure if I need the rest. Cardboard quality, so-so. Can it last long? I don't know, it doesn't have any nice gloss or anything, any special print to it. It's just literally your very normal cardboard. There's no embossing. There's nothing special, nothing to shout about. Okay, let's just open. Open the cards. If you're a game producer, manufacturer, or whatnot that you're watching this, do include something to let players actually open this nicely. Not everybody is gonna have a scissors or knife just because they want to avoid damaging the card. To be honest, card quality is meh. Look at how easily it's bent. I'm not even putting much effort, so this probably feels, I don't know. Okay, this is the player 8, so maybe the player 8 has a weaker card. Construct? Nah. I don't know, it doesn't scream quality to me, to be honest. So let's hope the sleeve actually makes up for its shortfall. Looking at the size of the cuts, I'm sure I had to pay for the sleeve. I don't think it came free. Maybe it did, I don't know. I can't remember. Yeah, good sleeves. So this is at least 90 to 100 microns. And if you ship the sleeve with the game, it should fit like that. This is, you know the drill, this gets fast forwarded. Okay, so they actually give you more sleeves than the number of cards, which usually is a good sign. So there you have it, Dungeon Drop Deluxe. So if you like videos like this, do comment below, let us know what you like about videos like this. Tell us more games that you'd like to see from us. Give the video a thumbs up. Subscribe below. We have many people that view our videos but are not subscribed to us. I don't know, something like 95% of our viewers are not subscribers, which is amazing to me. But if you love our videos that much, please do consider subscribing to us. Turn on the notification bell. More videos are at the site. And we'll see you for the next one. Thank you for watching.